just seems like a good guy to have around.
The younger brunette, she comes off to me as kind of being the bitch. We have the long-haired guy that looks like the love child of Steven Seagal and The Last of the Mohican. So if he can pull any of those skills out, you know, survival skills like an Indian or karate moves like Steven Seagal, he's a good guy to have on your side, I think.
I'm gonna clean these things out.
The fish, we have just those little minnows to eat, but we found that brute that smells like a foot.
Jerry,
yeah.
All that Jatoba. Shut your mouth.
No, it's really, it's better than eating the thing.
I'm having a hard time sticking this in my mouth.
Come on, it's good.
This is a Brazilian fruit called Jatoba, and it's got like a really hard like pod shell on it, and then inside it's got this almost powdery flesh. It really makes you thirsty. It kind of sucks all the saliva out of your mouth. But here, there's nothing else to eat. So it's, I guess it's like God's candy in Brazil. So thanks, God.
Okay, you think I should shed my underwear?
Being from Utah, you'd think I'd be a shirt and tie, nerdy glasses, but I'm probably not the stereotypical Mormon.
He's naked!
Wow.
I'm probably more of a free spirit.
Well, he doesn't want his clothes wet for the challenge.
Okay, this is not gonna be pretty.
Having somebody that can make you laugh in an environment like this where everybody's dirty and tired, I think people appreciate that.
You can look if you want.
It's your show, Tyson.
But when it comes down to it, I want that $1 million. Exotic, expensive furs on my shoulder, jewels on these pretty fingers. We're talking big time. I'll wear a tiara, a man tiara. Do they make those?
I think I just always smell like flowers and exotic fruits.
Who am I? Oh, that question. Who am I? Pretty well balanced individual, I'd say.
But I was bent over looking at the ground and you jumped right on top. Your boobs popped out?
Maybe.
That's fitting.
I'm not the stereotypical Mormon. I respect the church and the people in it, but for myself personally, you know, there's things I want to do and not necessarily that are sinning.
Oh, no.
We'll see what happens when I get home and everyone disowns me.
You'll never be able to have children again.
I don't care. I'll probably have to move somewhere else, somewhere less Mormon-y. Our tribe's going to tribal council, so we're gonna have to take somebody out. Sierra's probably the one to go. She didn't make the trek with us at the beginning. I mean, she's trying, but it looks like she's numero uno on the chopping block.
Sierra was on my mind at first.
Yeah, that's what I was feeling. Coach, he wants to get rid of Candace. You know, I didn't necessarily think he was right. In the challenge yesterday, as hard as Sierra played, I think that she's just too small for something like that. Every time I saw her, she was trying her hardest, but somebody was holding her down. So I think there's gonna be some challenges that probably would suit Candace better than they would Sierra. One word to describe Coach, I think that's it, Coach. You know, he's not always the best at what he's coaching, but he thinks he knows the most.
I mean, you, me, Sierra, and Debbie are gonna vote Aaron off next. It doesn't matter what Brendan thinks. I'm sure he'll be with us, because that's 4-3.
He likes his voice to be heard, which is what we all want and need.
You're like my assistant coach, and like we always just see things. We don't even have to talk, and I think that's gonna be it. But as we're getting to know each other, you know, yeah. The first 7 days, I wanna make sure you saw it the exact same way as I did.
You know what? When he told me I was like his assistant coach, more power to me, you know.
Yeah, cool. Stick it. Yep. Sweet. I'm glad we're seeing it exactly the same. I love it.
But he has a little schoolboy crush on me. People see that. He loves me, you know. So if I just keep plugging away, I'll eventually make coach. He may promote me. I don't know if I'll have my own team or we'll be co-coach or whatever, but people are gonna start calling me that. I'm actually gonna demand it. If we ever get put on separate tribes in this game, I will demand that the other tribe calls me coach too.
Taste of a good cheeseburger, I'll be back on top.
Mm. Yeah, I think Jerry's illness has put a couple eyeballs on him. I mean, if he's in pain and can't compete in the challenges, if he's the weak link and it comes to tribal council, he could be the next one to go. But anytime there's a blind side, it's pretty awesome. Just the look on somebody's face. I think Aaron wants to be here so, so bad that her getting blindsided would look really cool. I love seeing people cry when you crush their dreams.
We need it.
It's crazy not to have.
Last night at Tribal, we established leader, kind of. So I guess Brendan or Coach is the leader. I don't know. I wasn't paying attention. I don't really care.
Tyson. Joe.
Man. You too, man.
Good game, man.
It felt a little weird having those two guys from the other tribe come in.
We get you a cocktail?
Yeah.
You want to be on good terms with them because you're probably going to be living with them in the future. But in the back of your mind, you're like, I want to punch these guys in the head. For the most part, I've written Aaron off. I mean, I haven't really talked to her one-on-one about anything. And she doesn't hang out with the tribe a lot. Plus, I think she'll be really, really upset when she gets voted off. And I'd like to see a freak out at Tribal. I think that would be fun.
I've actually buried it. Go to the bathroom on myself.
Okay. Coach is a coach, you know? Right now, I'm mostly agreeing with what he says. But in this game, I don't perceive him as being near the player that I am. I don't know what's going on in Brendan's head, but he's made a lot of contact with the other tribe. Whether he's built up friendships or alliances, I don't know, but he definitely seems to have some of their respect, and it could get dangerous.
This is definitely the worst storm we've had since we've been here. The worst part about it is that it doesn't look to be stopping.
I'll go get a spoon.
It's dark everywhere, thunder, probably lightning. We're trying to stay warm in our shelter, but it's leaking. Now I'm out here getting completely drenched. My nipples are hard. It's awesome.
Scared of man.
I'd like to get rid of Brendan. He's the biggest threat. He just seems like a sneaky bastard, you know? I can't look him in the eye and believe a word he says. You can look me in my sweet blue eyes all day, and I'll tell you sweet nothings, and you'll believe all of them. I talked with Brendan, and I just wanted to kind of let him feel like that I was still on board with whatever plan he had. I do feel proud being a better schemer than Brendan. He's supposed to be this bigwig businessman who gets businesses rolling, makes them tons of money. He's like putty in my hands. I can mold this game however I want right now.
Right on the lips.
Love you.
I love you too, sweetie. Here, want to try it on?
Yeah.
Yeah, so I kick ass like I always do, and if any ladies want my phone number, I guess ask. Lying to everybody, especially Brendan and Sierra, actually brings me pleasure. In my alliance now, Steven and JT have replaced Brendan and Sierra. I never liked Sierra ever. I have no clue why she's out here other than to just give hope to stupid people around the world. And Brendan, he's really the sneakiest bastard I have to worry about. We smile at each other, we hug. I've kissed him on the neck, softly. He's felt my warm, steamy breath on the nape of his neck, even on the small of his back. But, you know, as the old adage goes, keep your friends close and your enemies closer. That's right, right? Brendan lives to see another day. I am disappointed. The main thing about getting the plan to work was keeping everybody quiet for long enough to vote him out so that he didn't use an idol if he had it. Now, I don't know how much is gonna leak or what's gonna happen, but...
We're throwing underhand breaking tiles. None of us have ever done this in our lives.
I have.
Coach likes to have the attention. I mean, all the great stuff he's done sounds almost too good to be true. I mean, I expect Brendan trying to scheme. I'm not really that worried. Brendan being gone with JT and Debbie, those are two of the strongest allies, so it actually worked out well. I just hope the extra food Brendan gets isn't gonna hurt our chances for winning immunity. I started this plan to eliminate Brendan days ago, but due to default, we didn't even go to Tribal. I've already got it set up so 4 votes go to Brendan, 3 votes go to Sierra. If Brendan gets wind of it, uses his idol, Sierra's gone. Brendan's gone in 3 days from that. I'd like to see him go first, because I'd like 3 days of just bossing her around and telling her to shut up. Probably won't win me her vote from the jury, but it would probably win me everybody else's vote. So it would be a win-win for me. Tribal was awesome. My plan worked perfectly. Brendan's out. It couldn't have gone better. Now I just have to deal with Sierra. You're just long-winded, and it's just all the same.
I'm just trying to make my peace, that's it.
I was pretty harsh with Sierra, but she didn't want to take the credit for anything that had happened. I knew what she'd do. I knew she'd backpedal and scramble and try and get people on her side, but nobody's falling for it.
I'd sure never treat any of you guys like this if it was vice versa.
Okay. Prodigal daughter returns. I'm very happy Sierra's going next. In your face. Eat it, Sierra.
But I wasn't about to go on some massacre against you. And I wasn't about to go on some massacre against Coach.
But you did. I'd like to see Sierra scramble and mope. I think it's funny because I've never liked Sierra. To me, she's of no worth. I mean, her parents probably love her. I can't imagine her boyfriend's that cool.
Steven says he's gonna eat. JT says he's gonna eat. Coach says he's gonna eat.
So Coach is hungry enough to quit a game and eat pizza. When do I get my pizza, dude? I've been winning all these challenges, you know? They should let me have pizza and not worry about sealing the deal to get rid of Sierra.
There's nothing awesomer than seeing somebody celebrate before the game's over.
I would have liked to have the immunity necklace again. I thought it would be pretty badass if I would have worn it for a third time. But tonight's Tribal's Council is going to be awesome. I'm hoping that Sierra will cry a lot. Sneaky bastards. Now I know how Brendan feels. Yeah, it was a big shock. I thought I had my game in the bag, but should have probably not been quite as confident or so gullible. Good luck to everybody. I guess everybody deserves to be there. You beat me. That's a huge accomplishment. That bothers me that Sierra will be here longer than me. A little weird being outfoxed by an idiot, but I'm not crying over it.
Funny guy, a really kind, really sincere guy, and taking him out was like the turning point of the game for us, I think.
I think the blind side actually, for most people, comes when they're the most confident. And I was definitely overconfident. I was like, I got this game wrapped up. But it's usually not the strongest person that wins. The more pathetic you look and act, usually seems to get you pretty far in the game. So those people can have their money. I'll keep my awesome personality and fantastic good looks.